Hello, Next.js Conf. Thank you for having me as one of your speakers. I'm so excited to be here virtually with you all. In the next 10 minutes, I'll take you on a journey of leveling up your Next.js developer experience using cloud development environments. Let's begin. So if you don't know me already, I'm Pauline Narvas and I head up the community at Gitpod. I first found out about Vercel and Next.js at a hackathon, actually, back when I was a student. Since my very first touchpoint with Next.js, it's been my go-to framework in every project I spin up. And I spin up quite a lot of projects. Outside of the tech world, I'm a digital nomad. In the past year, I've been to 11 countries, but I've been drawn to the beautiful country of Greece. Feel free to connect with me on Twitter or on LinkedIn. And as I'm going through my talk, share your learnings with me. I'd love to read them after. Let's kick this off. I'm going to go through a few slides and I would love to hear in the chat if these scenarios have ever happened to you. Have you ever been waiting for an NPM install to complete and it just feels like it's taken forever? This one is a classic where your code works only on your machine and no one else's. I'm sure you've all felt this pain where it's been 2 weeks since you first joined and you still haven't committed a line of code because your dev environment setup is just not working. Or perhaps you've stumbled across a cool open source project that you would love to contribute to, but it has a long contributing process and a README that tells you to install XYZ dependencies, but still you want to power through. You may either be in an engineering team that is working with Next.js, or you're an individual developer looking to use Next.js as your next framework, or you're an open source contributor wanting to contribute to Vercel's open source projects. In every single scenario I've just talked about, you need to go through and select your project, check your dependencies, check out the branch, view a README, install tools, run your build, run your test, and finally, you can get started with coding. In other words, lots of friction. There are quite a few speed bumps before you can actually reach creative flow. This is where cloud development environments come in, or CDEs. They are on demand and pre-configured with all the tools, libraries, and dependencies required to be ready to code. So at Gitpod, we've coined 4 CDE principles. The first one is CDEs are on demand. They are instantly available and infinite. So you can just click a button to open your dev environment anywhere, anytime. You can also start multiple dev environments for multiple contexts. The second principle we're focusing on is equitable, which is all about making software development more accessible to everyone. Let me share a real-life example of this within our team. Axon landed his job here because of his active participation within our community. Before joining Gitpod, he was learning how to code, but faced several hurdles when his Chromebook broke down. But did that stop him? Absolutely not. He managed to set up a workstation with a keyboard and a mouse, all connected to a TV using his Android phone and using Gitpod as his compute power. Our third principle is consistency. Now, what do we mean by that? Well, in the world of Gitpod, every cloud development environment can be tailored to meet your specific needs. Think of this as infrastructure as code. It's the shift from treating infrastructure like pets, which are unique, to treating them like cattle, where each unit is identical. And the biggest win? No more configuration drift. Every setup is consistent. And last but not least, our final principle is extensibility. And this means that every CDE is not only modular, but also powerful enough to handle any use case that you throw at it. So let's go back to the scenarios I talked about earlier. So for all of them, they select a project. In this case, it's a Next.js project. And we remove all the friction. We can just start coding to get into that creative flow. Let's see this in action. All you need to do to start a cloud development environment is click this open in Gitpod button. You can also prefix your URL with gitpod.io/hash. But for now, since I've got the extension installed, I'll just click this button. I'm opening up a new workspace. A workspace is your development environment running in the cloud. If we head over to the Gitpod YAML file, this is the configuration file that keeps your environment consistent. You can open multiple workspaces and go through the same flow we just went through again and again for different tasks. And then once you're done making changes in that workspace, you can just get rid of it and forget about it once you've committed. Once this Gitpod workspace opens, what happens is we start your development environment by doing a npm install with all of your dependencies, and then a run dev, which starts up the dev environment, which you can see here. I've opened up an issue here to say hello to Next.js Conf, and you can just start a completely new workspace here. Again, you've got the Gitpod button, and what it does is it creates a branch based off this issue. We'll just start a new workspace. Let's just head over to pages and just make changes to the index. We'll say, hello, Next.js conf. And we'll save. Now, what we'll do is we'll commit these changes. And we'll just open up a new terminal. We can do a git push. And we can actually create a pull request directly from Gitpod. And we'll create that. And you can review that PR directly from Gitpod. Other cool things you could do is share your workspace. This could be helpful if you're collaborating with a colleague or a fellow open source contributor for your project. You could just share your workspace and debug on issues together. Gitpod is fully customizable. You can make changes to your themes, install any tool or dependency that you need for your specific project. You could also start your Gitpod workspaces directly from the dashboard. As you can see here, I've opened quite a few Next.js workspaces. You can also go to your user settings here and go to preferences. So I know as developers, we are very tied to our unique dev environment, but you can customize your Gitpod experience to suit your needs. What I showed you in the demo was using VS Code in the browser, which is the quickest way, but you can also use VS Code Desktop, and also we have integrations with IntelliJ and Terminal. You can also choose a theme and customize your workspaces even further using dot files. You can really make your cloud development environment your own. Adopting cloud development environments can truly revolutionize the way you develop apps using Next.js. Imagine faster onboarding into your projects, opening up the doors for more contributions, and facilitating easier collaboration with your team. All of this can be achieved with just a click of a button or prefixing your Git URL. So you can develop, preview, and ship even faster. And from anywhere. Try it yourself. Simply prefix your Next.js project's URL on GitHub, GitLab, or Bitbucket with gitpod.io/hash. Once you've given it a shot, we'd love to hear more about your experiences. Share your stories, insights, and feedback with our community. Thank you once again for welcoming me here today. Enjoy the rest of Next.js Conf, and happy coding, everyone.